Hello and welcome to the channel, SSJ Quinny here, and today I'm coming at you guys with a very quick, short, and brief video on Dragon Ball Super Chapter 68. Now, I'm not going to be going over the whole entire chapter, I'm just going to be going over the important things, talking about possible new forms and possible new forms of Ultra Instinct. And to anyone who's been subscribed to this channel for a long time, I just feel like I owe this to you. I'm sorry for not making a video for a long time. I am great and doing well, life's just been very busy. That's not what this video is about though, so I'm going to move on and make another video on that soon, but I hope you're all happy and healthy and doing well. Anyways, let's start. So, as you can see, it starts off here with Goku using Ultra Instinct against Whis. So it is now confirmed Goku can use Ultra Instinct at will and he has full control of it. But we end up getting some more information here. So, Goku goes at Whis. Now remember, this isn't a full chapter review, so I'm not showing it all. But Goku goes at Whis with basically an after image kind of like move. And he basically goes at Whis with a bunch of after images he control, almost like after image shadow clones, and he gets knocked out of Ultra Instinct. Now, this is where we get the first important information on Ultra Instinct. Vegeta asks Beerus if Whis is using Ultra Instinct, as he doesn't really know. Beerus says, no, not really, angels are always using Ultra Instinct. So, kind of like how Goku has Ultra Instinct like a form, all the angels are constantly always using Ultra Instinct. So that's pretty cool. We kind of already knew that, but it is really cool that the manga elaborated on that and explained it a bit. Really happy they did that. So that's pretty cool. But there's more. And bingo, right here is where we start getting even more interesting information about Ultra Instinct. So, Whis just briefly says to Goku, basically, your goal isn't just to use Ultra Instinct that you have now and wield it. In fact, this is only the starting point. He then goes on to say that himself, he has greater command over Ultra Instinct than Mirus did, the angel from the Moro Saga. And also, the Grand Priest's Ultra Instinct is even more accurate hiss. And Goku then remarks, oh, so I'm at the bottom of the ladder. And Whis says, yes, pretty much. You still have a lot of room to grow, though. And Goku does the whole, oh, I'm excited to even get stronger kind of thing. But very interesting information here. So I guess what I'm wondering is when Goku starts tapping into Ultra Instinct, meaning he can probably get just as good as Whis, is he going to get a new form or is it just going to stay the same? We have no way of knowing now, but there is a possibility that we will get more and more Ultra Instinct forms and different appearances while Goku taps deeper into the form. We don't know if the form's going to change, but we definitely know that Goku still has a ways to go with Ultra Instinct. He's still only at the beginning. Very cool stuff and information from this chapter here. But there's even more. So, if you're wondering, Vegeta's viewpoint is still the same on Ultra Instinct. Beerus asks him if he's going to try to learn it, because he's obviously falling behind Goku quite a bit now, and he still says that it doesn't suit him, but he's still looking to surpass Goku in another way, so that's really cool. But Beerus says that it might be possible, and then, huge moment here, he reveals that Ultra Instinct is not the only technique of the gods. Wow, we never knew anything about this yet. He states that it's just the angel's special ability. And that he also states that, oh, do you really think that all the gods of destruction would run around using a move where you have to be emotion-free and calm and all that stuff? Basically, he's explaining the same way where Vegeta's like, yeah, that move isn't suited for me. It's also not suited for all of the gods of destruction either. Even though Beerus has been known to very slightly use Ultra Instinct, but just not have perfect control over it either. So, yeah, this is huge, huge news. This basically means that we might see more god forms that are different than Ultra Instinct, but sort of the same, as in, you know, they're not a form of Super Saiyan, but they're just a technique that the gods can use. And there's a possibility that Goku and Vegeta might get these forms, and Vegeta might get his own new form. As for what it might be, I don't know, but very, very interesting news here. Vegeta asked Beerus to teach him, but he says he'll pass because he's not really a teacher and he's going to do some exercise. And about him saying, if you want anything, feel free to steal it. I don't really get what he meant here, but this is also the chapter just came out, so it could be rough translation.
So, yeah, is Vegeta going to get a new form? Is Goku also going to use these new forms? Are they going to use them with Ultra Instinct? Are you going to be able to combine them with Ultra Instinct? Another thing that I'm wondering is, is Goku's Ultra Instinct going to change? Is he going to change in appearance when he starts getting further into it? And another thing I'm wondering is, are all these new forms or Ultra Instinct along with it going to be able to be combined with Super Saiyan 1, 2, 3, maybe even Super Saiyan God, maybe even the Kaioken? We have no clue. And again, I'm sorry if this review was pretty quick. If you wanted to see a whole new review of the chapter, there's definitely spots you can read it online. The way I see it is, well, if you can read it online, why do you just want to watch somebody else just speak over it, right? I don't have a lot of time to make a video, so I wanted to make it very quick. Please, if you feel like it, comment on your thoughts down below. And that's pretty much it for the video. Again, to any longtime subscribers, I'm sorry I've been gone away for so long. Nothing really crazy. I've just been really busy lately and, just busy part of my life, trying to get a place of my own and all that stuff. And yeah, life's just been crazy busy. But I'll make another video on that. I don't want to explain it on this one, maybe the next one or something like that. And I'm also in that video, I'm going to explain future video plans and all that stuff too. I just wanted to make this video really quick. I don't like it when videos drag on and people just make up like crazy assumptions. Like, this is official news, so I really wanted to share it. And yeah, that's it. Anyways, thank you guys all for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope it was quick, concise, and to the point. If there's anything I can change or anything you didn't like about the video, please comment down below. And if you feel like giving your thoughts, opinions on this chapter in the comments down below, you go right ahead, because it was a really good chapter. I think you guys should go read it, because there's other interesting stuff other than that just happened. Anyways, guys, that's it. Sorry for rambling on here at the end. You guys have a fantastic day. Stay safe, happy, and healthy, and COVID-free. And that's it. Have a great one. Bye.